Okay, y'all, I'm back.
I'm so sorry. I know that is very unprofessional. I'm trying to do some shit, work on my technology, trying to get the lights and shit together. I told y'all 2016, set my motherfucking game up and shit. For y'all, for those of y'all who are tuning in for the first time, this is my trending topics video. And I go from here, what's up? I go from here to YouTube, okay? So trying to set the game and shit up. That's why y'all see the black screen, because hello, because when I'm done with this, it will be on YouTube, and I'm going to edit this and give y'all some good shit, okay? So, I got some shit to talk about, hey? And, you know, we going to get this shit in, all right? Oh, this your first time? All right, here's the thing. I say some crazy shit. Everybody else here who typically tunes in say some crazy shit, all right? So, it's one of those where if I talk about your faves and shit, don't get mad at me, okay? It is what it is, so for those of y'all who don't know, I'm going to go ahead and sip on my drink. This right here is at Concord Grape Crystal Light. Y'all know a motherfucker losing weight and shit, bodybuilder.com. They don't pay my ass, but, you know, free advertising for their ass. Oh, thank you so much for sharing. Yeah, y'all please share this shit with y'all peoples now. Please do. Okay, hold on. Let me go ahead and get a puff on my damn vape, and we about to get in. Alright. What's hood? How we doing? All right, so actually, let me sit this down, because like I said, I didn't take the protect off this, so I ain't trying to bust up my shit, but I'm sitting that down. So let me go with my notes. Let's start off with Pedophiles Unite, all right? Talking about two, dare we say pedophiles. So the first is going to be Young Thug. I don't like talking about him on the trending topics, but in these next two cases, for what it's worth, I'm going to say allegedly. Well, the second one really isn't, but allegedly, he likes little kids. All right, so in addition to all of his other antics, he went on IG and hit up this woman and pretty much says, "Your son is sexy and so are you." And they show that her son is a fucking toddler. As old boy said, had your wife, had your kids, had your purses, had your man, had every motherfucking body. But that's some crazy shit. Like, the boy's a toddler and you saying her son is sexy? The fuck is you on? Like, what he needs to do is, why he's worried about, exactly, why he's worried about how, now again, this shit is allegedly, but pending this shit is true, why you so worried about how sexy her fucking son is, why don't you worry about your motherfucking child with gold-plated motherfucking grill saying I'm motherfucking tired on motherfucking social media? Why don't you worry about your motherfucking baby mama embarrassing your ass and your damn family and your fucking legacy? Why are you worried about somebody else's motherfucking child? Okay. And right quick, if y'all notice, I don't have a yarmulke on right now because I got my hair, you know, natural, you know, air dry, you know, no blow drying and shit over here, but just want to put that out there. Now I got that motherfucker out of the way. Let's talk about Tiger. I'm on the fence about this shit, and I'm gonna let y'all know why. First, I'm gonna give y'all, you know, the allegedness. Even though, for what it's worth, because I only say alleged because I still haven't heard anything necessarily from him. But rumor has it that he has been IGing a, I believe she's 14 years old. Either she's 14 or 16, but a teenage supermodel, or not supermodel, but a model on IG has been IGing her, saying that, you know, she's cute, this, that, and the third. And the young girl, who her name is, she's choosing to be unknown, did an interview and pretty much stated that, you know, he had been IGing her, in addition to asking for her phone number, has been texting her that, you know, she's cute, this and third. And by the IG, if this is truly him, and if it was truly him doing it, it seems as if she took it as, oh my gosh, he's a celebrity, he's, you know, he thinks that I'm amazing, yada yada, blah blah blah. Now this shit comes out, the latter part came out later, but you have the IG shit. He goes on and pretty much states, and I believe this was Twitter, that let me see, they trying to put another scandal on me. And then he posts a link to his music video titled Scandal, and then came the interview with old girl. Now I feel some kind of way about this. On one hand, I think he could possibly be doing this for a publicity stunt, Possibly, because this shit comes out and then he's capitalizing on this. And it's not like the shit happened. He hurried up and shot a music video and it's just miraculously ready to be put out there. Because this all happened within a week. But at the same exact time, if we think about the whole Kylie Jenner situation and how I think she was 16 when he initially started fucking with her and they didn't go official public until she was 18, I don't know how the fuck to feel about this. So, y'all let me know right now before I move on to the next topic. How do y'all feel about that? Because I don't, like I said, I don't know. Like, because here's the thing, on some real shit, if he's truly doing this shit, if y'all watch my last video, I'm not against capital punishment. I'm not. I've already said bring back throwback punishments and executions. I've already fucking said that. And for a motherfucker like him, yeah, I'm gonna be straight up with you. If he's really doing shit like this, yes. Keep his ass alive. Keep his ass alive. Have his ass chained up. Chop off his damn dick. Burn that shit shut, and then send the motherfucker on his merry motherfucking way. I guarantee you, he ain't gonna be sitting. I mean, here's the thing: he can comfort him all the fuck he want, but what can he do? You know what I'm saying? Like, that's just me. I know. Maybe y'all thinking, boy, you fucking crazy. Move on. All right, I'm move on. Since y'all don't want to talk about the shit, okay. So. Yeah. All right. So, moving on. Now, Walmart has pulled Rick Ross's album titled "Black Market" off of their website. I don't know if they necessarily pulled it from the stores, but they pulled it off their website because one of their analysts, I guess, listened to the album. And you miss Wendy. Okay, hold on. I ain't no Wendy Williams now, but I'm gonna talk about that hoe too. But I ain't no Wendy Williams. Let me say that right quick, okay? Like I said, she might be, a man dressed as a woman and shit, and she lied about her shit. But hey, I'm all real over here. But they pulled his album because there's a lyric in one of his songs that says "assassinating Donald Trump like Zimmerman," and it's because of that they pulled his album off their website. Now, my thing is this: they have every right. Walmart has every right to do that, but what I don't even want to really talk about that. I mean, if y'all want to discuss it, we can talk about it. Y'all let me know how y'all feel about that. But the one thing that I want to mention is last week, I did talk about, I believe her name is Stacey Dash. Like I said, y'all know I already talked about the whole fag hacks on Periscope. I don't know about, I don't know about them. I really don't. Sorry. But last week I told about Stacey Dash being fired, well, not fired, but suspended from Fox News because she has, like I said, she spoke out about the president, which I'm not against, like everybody has freedom of speech, but just how vulgar and how nasty, what she was saying was about him. I wasn't here for it. I didn't like it and I didn't appreciate that. And I also made mention that like I said, if it was done to any other president, and I'm not trying to necessarily bring color into this, but remember what happened with the Dixie Chicks. They spoke out against George Bush, and literally they have been blackballed. I mean, whitewashed, whatever the fuck you want to call it, but they're, I mean, we really haven't heard anything from them, and I haven't heard anything from them since "I'm Not Ready to Make Nice." You feel what I'm saying? okay. All right, I'm not gonna talk about that, cause I might, like I said, if anything, I might talk about that next week. But like I said, that's not what I have on the list right now. Sorry. But with that being said, and even other presidents, people come against them and say something, many of their careers and everything else has been halted. People come up and say a lot of stuff about our current president, nothing happens to them. Now we have a candidate who is Donald Trump. So there is a line talking about assassinating him like Zimmerman, and Rick Ross's album gets pulled. This is shit that I don't like. Again, it's one of those where if we gonna sit here and do the freedom of speech, then it needs to be across the board. But I don't like, this is okay. Like I said, because again, I mean, if we gonna be honest and true about this shit, because y'all know I ain't one to bite my motherfucking tongue, so we can sit here and say whatever the fuck we want. I'm not gonna say, here's the thing, like I said, this is probably your first time watching me. There is a reason, like I said, I'm talking about it without talking about it, because like I said, I mean, for what I do for a living, I will not talk negatively about the president. All right, I will let you read between the lines of what I probably do as a profession. But regardless of whether he puts himself out there like that or not, I don't think that it's okay that we've given other people a pass. When it comes to him, people can say whatever they want, and people have said some hateful shit. People have made threats against him, and nothing has happened. People have made threats against other presidents, and they asked to have gone straight the fuck to jail. What I'm saying is that, you know, everything's not fair across the board. What's good for the goose is not good for the gander. And that's all that I'm saying. So I'm going to move on to the next damn subject. So let's talk about James Wright. Yeah, everybody is. Everybody. Here's the thing. Even me, and I'm not a public figure, but even me doing YouTube and Periscope, I'm open to, you know, slander scrutiny. It is what it is, you know. But all that I'm saying is that if it's fair for, you know, us to do this to, you know, one person that is, you know, a public figure in this, I guess on this stage or on this particular platform, it should be free game for everybody. But we're gonna leave that alone. And I want to talk about James Wright, Patti LaBelle, and Steve Harvey. Now, in general, a lot of people have had a lot of shit to say about Auntie Patti, and y'all already know, like, it's certain people. I'm on a team now. I'm gonna call a motherfucker out and they fuck shit. I will definitely do that. But y'all know that I stood up for Miss Auntie Patti LaBelle in reference to everything that was going on. And I don't think it was last week, but it was one of my Periscope videos that I did talk about that. Thank you. It's green screen, but just wait till it go up on YouTube. The shit gonna be, you know, it's gonna be everything. But you know, and I even said, just given everything, you know, Patty is not wrong for. I'm gonna talk about that in a minute. But what I'm saying about, you know, the whole Patty thing is everybody was like, she's wrong for not paying him this, that, and the third. And it's one of those where it's just like, we don't know what happened. You know what I'm saying? And here's the thing. I do believe that she paid him. I do. But let's look at this realistically. If James Wright came out and said, yes, Patty paid me. And if Patty came out and said, yes, I paid him. Do you know what would happen? That's a big ass target on his back. We don't know where he stays, but if people do, they know to run up on him because he got money. You feel what I'm saying? Now, even if Patti LaBelle did not pay him, yes, we could sit here and say that she's carrying him around like an accessory, but let's look at on the other side of the coin. She's giving this man exposure. Exposure like he has never gotten it. I didn't see it. I haven't recorded because I record Patti LaBelle's place. Like I said, I love Auntie Patty, and you will not convince me otherwise now. Ah-ha-ha! Well, all right now. But had him on there, you know, and apparently I think they did three pies. They were singing and whatnot. You know, he got a chance to meet her. You have that. Also on the Steve Harvey show, he's actually had other interviews on other platforms, right? Both of them are on the Steve Harvey show talking about the pies. He reviewed the bacon. I'm talking about the bacon in a minute. But, you know, reviewed the bacon. It's, you know, sitting there broke into almost a hymn and even had a slight chance, but he was able to promote his single that is on iTunes. So if we now here now are we gonna say and like I said, y'all already know I'm Patti LaBelle all day long. And if we want to sit here and say that she's carrying him around like an accessory, I can say that too. You know what? Possibly, but what I will say is this, honestly, compared to the Real Housewives and how they use the gays as accessory. If it's any Tamar Stone here, I'm sorry, I'm finna piss y'all off. But like Tamar Braxton, she uses, you know, her gay assistants as accessories. But what do they get out of it? Nothing. But you have Patti LaBelle. Well, if you're talking about when Patti LaBelle said that it was all me, I don't think that that was her dissing him. I think that was her strategically playing this out. Like I said, y'all will have to catch my other Periscope video because I'm not trying to stay on this too long, but I kind of want to give you guys background on what I'm saying. But again, if we're going to say that Patti LaBelle is using him as an accessory, that's fine. But what Patti LaBelle is doing that other people are not is she is giving him the opportunity to branch out and brand himself. So again, let's give Auntie Patty that. But what I do want to say is, so they're on the Steve Harvey show promoting Steve Harvey's bacon that is at many different retailers, but I guess Walmart, I guess, gonna be like the primary distributor. Now, I don't eat pork. Y'all know for obvious reasons, like I said, my faith is Judaism, so y'all already know I don't eat pork. It is what it is. And I'm not mad at them for that, but first and foremost, Steve, really? Bacon? Of all the things for you to slap your name on, you slap your name on bacon. And then you have this young man on here. I want some real shit. I'ma just say it. Cooning for you to do like a little mini, almost just a little praise break, because again, because he has blown up in such a way, you want to bring this to your platform, and then even says that he's going to do his own separate review on this bacon. It's just like, really? Exactly. Like, because his whole thing about his bacon is slightly pre-cooked and it only takes 2 minutes to cook. But even making a joke about, hey, you could eat this on your way to the emergency room, like, this is not something to truly make fun of, especially in the African American community. Hypertension is a big thing. Heart attack, stroke, blood clot, all this shit is a big thing. I know shit. I have high blood pressure right now. You know what I'm saying? Bringing all that shit down though. But this is not something to joke about. And then this man is talking about he has bacon wrapped bacon, candied bacon, chocolate bacon, bacon wrap dates. Come on, Steve. I'm gonna have to ask you to do a little bit better. Moving the fuck on. So, Real Households of Atlanta. So, I need to sit here and find it, you know, on my pad, because, like I said, I have it on here. So, because, stop that now. Fucking tablet want to sit here. This is a motherfucking, you know, Android. Those of y'all know me, everything is Apple. The only reason why I got this is when I got my new iPhone. This was a promotional deal where they were going to give it to me for like a dollar. And everything in this share, and then after I get this, when they come out with the iPhone 6S, that they want to sit here and offer the motherfucking iPad mini. I was too through. Y'all know I don't like Android. If y'all do, I'm sorry, but I don't fucking like Android because this shit. But anyway, so Real Housewives of Atlanta news. Like I said, it's come to the point where I cannot do a trending topic without talking about Real Housewives of Atlanta and love and hip hop. It is what it is. But Kenya Moore has pretty much gone to the magazine, OK Magazine, and I guess we could say threw some shade at Miss Kim Fields. So this is what she said. I have a hard time remembering that Kim is on the show because when I do see her, thank you for the hearts, thank you for sharing. When I see her, I fall asleep. So I have to wake myself up and just say, oh, okay, I must have missed what she was doing because I'm bored. It's a strange situation. I've never seen a woman near 50 cry from being away from her children or her husband for actually less than 24 hours, so I don't know what to make of that. Now here's okay, Team Toro. I see. Now here's the thing. Even though I be now I'm not Team Toro though, but even though I be on teams, thank you for sharing. Thank you so much, y'all. Even though I am on certain teams, like y'all know I'm team on these all day long and shit. You know, I will still call somebody on they fuck shit. Now, let's call a fucking spade a spade. If we're gonna look at this from the big picture and the big realm, Real Housewives of Atlanta is on, right? Everybody has their things to say about Kim, right? So, and Real Housewives of Atlanta comes on actually tonight. And hey, Bo, Real Housewives of Atlanta comes on tonight, and it's gonna be another climactic either fight or near fight, right? So it's only right that something like this comes out right before this episode is to come out. Because in her talking about it and whatnot, what is going to happen? For those, like, same as if people checked out and they're not watching Real Housewives of Atlanta season, I think this is it eight? I think it's eight. It might bring a few more people to come watch the show. It's bringing attention. A lot of people have this whole thing where any publicity is good publicity. So on the big scale, that is exactly what this is. Okay, is publicity for the show. And I have no issues with that. And here's the thing, Kenya is helping people with their damn storylines. Because again, let's be honest, if it's not. She ain't lying though. But We have to at least give it up to Kenya, because if it's not for her, she is pushing so many people's storylines. It's ridiculous. And I got that. I got that. All right. Well, welcome back now. Welcome back. But what I'm saying is, y'all have to think about it. Kenya is pushing people's storylines along. Kenya is helping to start some of this drama. Okay. Here's the thing. I'm team on these, but fuck Marla. I ain't fucking with Marla. Okay. Fuck her. Anyway. But, you know, like, even with the whole Sheree thing. Yeah, she came to Sheree with the ship, right? But here's the thing, because people want to sit here and say it's boring. Has she not told Sheree what the fuck happened? Yeah, fuck Marla. Has she not told, you know, Sheree what happened, we wouldn't have had that, you know, somewhat meteoric, damn, I can't talk right now. We wouldn't have had that damn scene, right? Has she not, you know, been ready to sit here and kick bitches off the boat, we wouldn't have had the Cynthia Bailey, Chun-Li, Bruce Lee, Jackie Chan kick, okay? We wouldn't have had that. You feel what I'm saying? So y'all can say what y'all want. And I'm about to say some shit about Kenya, don't get me wrong, but in terms of pushing storylines and whatnot, that is what she is doing. So let's not take that from her. But Kenya, I'm going to have to ask you to simmer the fuck down now, because here's the thing, you may not necessarily understand it. Look, y'all. Look now. I don't see it for Dr. Heavenly, so let's not even do that. I don't see it for Dr. Heavenly. But what I'm saying is, Kenya, even though I love your antics, you can't, like, what I need you to do is slow it the fuck down, because you may not see why she's like this, but the same shit you don't see is the same shit that you want. You don't see how it is to long for somebody you love and long for a part of you because you are not with a man and you don't have any children that you have bared your fucking self. So let's not do that. Like, I'm all for you sitting here pushing storyline shit, but that's one of them things where you don't want to mess with that. And here's the thing, like I said, I don't have kids. I have nieces and nephews. But for all the women out there that have children, let me know if I'm wrong. But when a motherfucker start talking shit like that and start talking shit about your egg and what the fuck you pushed out, last time I checked, most females will sit here and cut a bitch over that. Y'all let me know if I'm right or wrong. Because if I'm wrong, let me know. Because I have been wrong about some shit. And, you can. And like I said, she can't relate. All right. That's all I'm saying. So I'm going to leave this. Yeah, shit. Tammy got to go too. I'm trying to figure out why the fuck they didn't give Marlo a peach. You feel what I'm saying? Like, it's too fucking much, but it is what it is. Y'all know I'm going to tune in tonight. So, and like I said, I'm going to give y'all green screen and all that good shit. All right. She's an instigator, you know, but again, if she didn't instigate, we wouldn't have all the shit that we got. I heard that she had a peach and it was this episode that is coming up tonight that took the peach away. I heard it was this episode. So we're going to see exactly what happened. You know, I said, I'm going to be candid about it. For those of y'all who don't know, yes, I am on YouTube. All right. YouTube.com. And my name is Spilling All the Tea, spaced out, all that good jazz. Okay, all right, thank you so much. And, you know, so here's the thing. If y'all are not subscribed to me on YouTube, please go over there. Because, again, this video will be up with all the animations and everything. But I will do my review for The Real Housewives tonight. And we'll see what happens. But it looks like it's going to be good. Now, I get the feeling Andy is going to sit here and give me some fuck shit. I got a feeling that what's going to happen is we're going to get a build up to the motherfucking fight. And the fight not going to happen till next week. Now, if the shit happened, I'm going to be all types of pissed. I hope I'm wrong. Now, let's go ahead. Hold on now. Well, see, here's the thing. Marlo ain't got to do it, though. You know what I'm saying? Let Marlo do what Marlo does. Okay. Like I said, I'd rather have, you know, her husky voice rather than, you know, Tammy's deep voice and shit. Okay. No. I'm not the only one. There are others that do it. Like I said, I know Sean Bradley does it. Every now and again, Cemented does it. I do. Okay, then it's just three of us. There might be more, I don't know, but I said I like to put these on there. Like, the reason I come to Periscope, just for y'all that don't know, the reason I come to Periscope to do the trending topics videos, I like the interaction. I like for all of us to cut up, because I could easily just record it and just throw the shit on YouTube, but I'd rather let us all interact with each other and then upload it to YouTube, and then let everybody else that either don't have Periscope or that missed it get a chance to, you know, kind of like join in on the fun. So let's go ahead and talk about Wendell Williams, okay? He does. Now, I don't see it for Wendell. I don't see it for Wendell now. Now I'm gonna talk about two things, okay? Seriously, her voice, like, my voice deep in the morning. Like I said, depending on when you catch me, my voice is hella fucking deep. All right, I am a baritone and with a bass register, so my voice is deep. But as the day goes on, and you know, I get in everything and I loosen up my throat and everything. Like I said, my voice is what you get. But damn it, on her voice is deeper than mine all motherfucking day long. I don't know if I'm gonna read her to the afterlife, but I just got some shit to say because I'm tired of Wendell. I am. Now here's the thing. First and foremost, I do not watch her show. The only time that I watch anything related to this moose face ass heifer is when the shit is on the blog somewhere. All right, that is the only time. Don't do that. Don't do that. Don't call me out. I mean, I drop it every now and then. Don't do that. Don't do that. Got me blushing on camera. Stop that. All right. But first, I want to talk about her bringing up the Portia and Cynthia fight. Now, she has the audacity to. But she has the audacity to sit here and say that the Portia and yeah. But she is talking about how the Portia and Cynthia fight made her such a so ashamed to be black and wanted to apologize based off of, you know, two women's behavior. Now, let me say this. As a proud black man, no one's behavior will ever make me apologize to any fucking body for a whole group. I will not fucking do it. I will not. Okay? Like I said, and then the fact that she's ashamed to be black. Here's the thing, we don't want your ass. Nobody claimed you. Okay? Like, here's the thing. I need for her to go to the motherfucking forest and shit, find Rocky and Bullwinkle. Maybe they ass might claim because she already looked like a bad built motherfucking moose, but ain't nobody fucking claiming you. You know what I'm saying? And then you want to sit here and do this, but you don't want to talk about all the other housewives that have, you know, had fights and shit. If y'all think, I think it was New Jersey. Like, the only housewives that I watch is Atlanta. And if y'all don't know, I only watched it because of Candy, because I loved Escape. And it was Candy that brought me to Housewives of Atlanta. So, but I do remember that in New York, old girl that was on marriage boot camp, she threw her fucking leg, her fucking prosthetic. Ain't nobody said shit about that. I think it was fucking New Jersey, who was literally shaking the table, moving the table. And what was so bad about it is, if y'all watch South Park did a reenactment of that. So let's not fucking do that. Let's not act like the Real Housewives of Atlanta are the only ones that sit here and fight on stage. So I'm gonna need for her to stop fucking cooning, because that shit's not cool. It's really not. Hey, here's the thing. I'm proud that this black woman has a platform and she is making her coins. But what I don't like is for her to sit here and really do this shit right here. This upsets me more than anything, okay? Exactly. And I'm gonna watch Mom Watch when it come back on, because apparently this is the last season, because the last season literally woke me the fuck out. But this upcoming season is supposed to be the last one, so okay. Exactly. Exactly. So let me move. So let's go from her, you know, apologizing and I guess being ashamed to be black for wanting some black dick that don't belong to her. So Mac Wiles was on her show. I never been here for them. I never been here for either. I really haven't. But so Mac Wiles was on her show, right? And if y'all don't know, he was the gentleman that is in Adele's Hello video. Talking about that, now off rip, you can tell that she was lusting. She was enthralled. Her loins was motherfucking burning when he walked, because he hugged her and gave her ass a good hug. Apparently, he cracked her back. And then she was like, I love a man that smells good and that knows how to hug. So already she getting the hot. Then she asked him if he's in a relationship. He says he is not. And then, you know, he pretty much talking about relationships and whatnot. I know. And, you know, he's like, well, you know, I'm a Cancer. And, you know, my birthday is July 15th. She's like, I'm a Cancer. My birthday is July 18th. And then, you know, she literally is looking at him, is having hot flashes and shit. And then she brings up Seven Streeter and is asking him about that relationship. And here's the thing, y'all know Wendy want people to sit here and just give all the fucking business and whatnot. Exactly, but you were shamed. But and here's the thing, when she started getting the hots for him, did y'all catch the shade? He clocked her ass, and I don't think he knew that he clocked her. Thank you for advising me, but I don't know if y'all know that he clocked her, right? He was like, you know, well, I love dark-skinned girls. So she went from being all enthralled to, because she was playing with her and everything, she went from this to... You mad? Are you mad? You mad? Like what you mad about? You mad because he said that he liked dark-skinned women? The fuck over? Like, that shit straight up fucking blew me. Here's the thing. hold on, wait. She need to have an arena full of seats, okay? Stadium full of motherfucking seats. Because you're mad because he says that he loves dark-skinned women. Here's the thing, it's not my fault that you sit here and bleach your motherfucking skin and you trying to make everything on you sit here and blend the fuck together. It's not our fucking fault. But the fact that he is saying that she is a dark chocolate woman and I like dark chocolate. Again, you saw her fucking face broke. You bit it. Oh, shit, y'all cutting the fuck up. Y'all cutting up. But, I came with her. I can't. I cannot, so. But, yeah, when he said that, it made her feel some kind of way. Make her feel some type of way, okay? So. Time to. All right, now. Time to talk about two individuals, Meek Mills and Chris Brown. let me hit the vape because I need to get myself ready for this fuckery. Hold on, y'all. Hold for long. Okay, here we go. So, Meek Mill has been found guilty of violating his terms of parole, all right? And now he is facing up to 1 year. Up to 1 year. And okay, before I finish, in reference to Chris Brown, if I can be completely honest, I stopped listening to Chris Brown after his I Can Transform You song. Okay, I stopped listening to Chris then. I will give the album a good listen. I still have to get Monica's Code Red, because y'all know I love Monica. I love me some more. I'll listen to Chris Brown's album, but I mean, here's the thing, and y'all might click the fuck off when I say this, but he never had strong vocals to me to begin with. When he first came out, I mean, granted, I wasn't doing YouTube, but I had said that he has a very bright future. And I was right in that declaration. But in terms of, you know, giving me straight fucking vocals, no. I'm just saying. I'm sorry. Okay, I'm sorry. It, like I said, and at the same exact time, you know, for those of you who don't know, I was in Korea for 2 years. So anything that came out within that 2 year time frame from July 2013 to July 2015, missed out on a lot of that music as well. But back to Meek Mill before I get to Chris Brown being in his motherfucking feelings and shit. Meek Mill is facing up to 1 year. Now, because he did not do the right thing and just talk to his parole officer and make sure that he was good to do all this traveling, well, the judge kind of helped his ass out and let his ass know, you will not do any shows. He is confined to the southeastern part of Philly. I'm not saying he can't sing, but you right, he can't sing, though. He can't sing. And I'm just saying that, he can't sing. But he's been restricted to the southeastern part of Philly. Can't do shows or anything like that until his hearing, which is February 5th, 2016. So I think this is the judge's way of just saying, okay, well, since you didn't know the first time, I'm going to let you know right now. Now, Chris Brown took to Twitter, and I got his his tweets on my phone. So I'm going to go ahead and read them to y'all right quick. Hold on. Yeah. So he says, wish the judge could see the influence Meek Mill can have out of jail more than in it. Y'all want to lock him up, but what about Freddie Gray? I don't follow Chris, but I have yet to hear Chris say shit about Freddie Gray up until this motherfucking point. Next tweet. The system is set on bullshit. The DA and judges just get as high as the next man and fuck people's lives up. Chris, he knew that his ass was on fucking parole. Nikki knew his ass was on parole. Nikki is just as guilty as he is, because Nikki should have told him, motherfucker, you gonna stay your ass at home or your ass gonna be locked up. They won't let you out. So you already fucking knew. I'm not here for that. I know. It's Chris Brown. Y'all know he ain't stable. Next tweet. I ain't on probation, so I can tell y'all kiss my ass. Chris, you ain't on probation. Let us not forget, you done beat a bitch ass. Okay. What I'm gonna need for you to do is to not put incriminating shit on fucking Twitter. Because what motherfuckers fail to realize is, when this shit happens, I'm not here saying on some real shit, I am not trying to speak this into existence, but given his track record, he might end the fuck back up in court. Yeah, let a motherfucking judge who reads this shit get your ass, and they have to sit here and be over your motherfucking court case. Your ass might be on parole then, if you're even fortunate enough to fucking get it. You dumb motherfucker, you. Continuing on. Well, here's the thing. He bad about tweeting the lean, but then we got the shit right now. Right now. But you think the people are going to keep sitting around and letting this bullshit ride? Y'all want to take guns away so y'all can enforce martial law? I will give him that one. That one made sense. I will give his ass that one. Yeah, I said it. Again, I will give him that. Enforce with the eyes looking that way. Again, I will give Chris Brown, I'm giving him that. Y'all know I'm going to lift you. I'm going to build you up when I need to. Tear your ass down. I will give his ass that. DMV! Exclamation. Read that one more. Okay, all right. You think the people are going to keep sitting around and letting this bullshit ride? Y'all want to take guns away so y'all can enforce martial law? Next tweet. Yeah, I said it. Next tweet, enforce side eyes. Okay. I think he had like two more tweets. No, he had a couple more tweets. Hold on now, because the motherfucker was tweeting and shit. We act like this country hasn't been run off drug money and corrupt officials. The whole history of Miami is based off of cocaine. Open your eyes with the eyes. Being young black men in America, this is what we are brainwashed with. It's not Pookie up the block that's killing us. It's the plug. Good old America. We are blind to most of this shit because we are prisoners of our own minds and materials. Now, let me say this. Some of what he said in those tweets make a lot of sense. He made some valid points, but he's on some fuck shit too. You feel what I'm saying? And he has every right to say what he's going to say, but between the lead, I can't get with him trying to sit here and, you know, bridge one thing with another and try to make that shit mesh. It does not. Okay. And yes, I feel him on that, but him trying to say he can do better outside of prison than in prison. My thing is this. If you was dumb enough to do this shit, you gonna have to sit here and deal with the fucking consequences. It's that fucking simple. Regardless of what good he can do. You did, but my thing is this, stay the fuck out your damn feelings on some real shit. And if you want to sit here and speak out about these issues, what I'm gonna need for Chris Brown to do is get out your light-skinned feelings. Yes, I said it, light-skinned feelings. Get out your motherfucking light-skinned feelings. And if you want to sit here and you want to talk about these issues, be a man, get on camera and talk about these damn issues. That's all the fuck I'm going to say. But with the whole meat meal thing, I'm going to need for him to stop with them motherfucking Twitter fingers. Stop. Because you see where them Twitter fingers got motherfucking meat meal with Drake, right? Moving on. Okay, all right. Now, I'm almost done, y'all. I'm almost done because I know I done took up most of y'all motherfucking time. Shit, I'm 40 minutes into this shit. I'm almost done, y'all. I'm sorry. Now, y'all know if I was drinking, we would have really been on some shit, okay? But I'm just saying, you know, I mean, tea and shade, y'all, I mean, Drake does have a song that's nominated for a motherfucking Grammy that was a diss track. Oops. All right, so let's talk about some old dumb motherfuckers now. And this shit right here really, really upsets me and hurts my heart now. I try to give it to y'all the best way that I can. I really do. Y'all see I'm stepping up my damn game and shit. I'm trying to get y'all some good shit now. So, let's talk about TGT and this fuck shit. We gonna need to get some Dragon Balls if Drake wins that fucking Grammy. We gonna need some Dragon Balls, alright? Cause we gonna have to revive his ass. We gonna have to revive Meek. I'm not fucking lying, okay? Lord have mercy. We gonna have to have a seance or something, okay? Something. But anyway, the whole TGT, and y'all know, I forget which T comes before what T, but y'all know that's Tank, Genuine, and Therese. Tyrese, Lord have mercy. Well, actually, I meant that, Therese. I actually fucking meant that, indirectly. And y'all gonna see why. So let me go ahead and pull up to the little bitch shit that he did. Let me find the shit. Y'all know I'm using all my social media, my electronics and shit. So, Tyrese took to Instagram, and this is what he said. I'm sorry to break the news, whole lot of dots. TGT is done, more dots. It's not about fault. She stay doing too much, Teresa. Business is business. Me and Tank are still moving. We will forever love our brother G as brothers. We got too much history to turn this into anything negative. But you posted his damn IG. Even 112 are still together. Even Next is still together. And True. And New Edition. It's only three of us. We did one album. It was epic. Look, this, I did not post this, okay? Y'all see this? I did not post this. This is what the fuck he posted. I'm relaying this to y'all, giving y'all my opinion, but I'm sorry, okay? Oh, yeah, that was my shit, too. Yes, sweet, that was my shit. But continuing on, and now it's over. We have been forced to start looking into someone else. He is. Or me and T just might do it solo. The reason it worked is because of our history and mutual respect. I don't know. I'm just shocked and disappointed that I'm even putting up this post. Why would you fucking do that? Why? And if anything, if this is what y'all were going to do mutually as men and not Mitches, this, what is it? I think this is the LG7. I think that's what. I'm sorry, it's the G-Pass 7.0. Okay. It's okay. It's okay. I don't love it, but it's okay. It's getting the job done. But why would you do this, okay? It is. Some shit happened. But my thing is, if y'all were going to announce this, they could have hit up Genuine and been like, look, for us to save face. If you want, let's save face and let's get together and let's just do a video together right quick. No eye roll, no nothing. And we just sit here and just say mutually that the whole group is done and we all go our separate ways, okay? I got more, y'all. I got more. I got more about Teresa now. I got more. Exactly. But see, here's the thing. But what he's saying is one of two things. Either A, they're going to get someone new to replace Genuine, or he and Tank are just going to go ahead and just be a fucking duo. But why are you putting all this shit on social media? Now, I have a theory. But hold on, because the shade continues. But Genuine responded. I was not happy that Genuine responded because he should have left the shit alone. But Genuine, he did an at to motherfucking Tyrese. Now here's the thing, y'all. Like, I'm not here for Teresa, but because here's the thing, Teresa did this fucking tweet, right? Did not at Genuine, did not even say his whole name, just put G. I don't know if y'all can see it, but Genuine at Teresa when he posted this shit and said, "Wow, really to post personal business? Shit is a pussy move, nigga." Why would you do that? And since you want to do that, keep it going and we will expose all diva. Let's get it. Be a fucking man, not a little boy. Talk to me, call. Don't try and manipulate the situation publicly. Whack, whack, whack of you. Exactly. Why is it the way it is? Now, here's the thing. I'm here for it. But I really feel that Genuine just shouldn't have said shit. Should have just let the shit go. You feel what I'm saying? Just because there's no need to address him. Yeah. Now here's the thing though. Now you said Tank ain't said nothing. Hold on now. Hold on now. Hold on. Y'all gotta go looking for it. But Tank did show a video of Genuine being supposedly high during one of their performances that I'm just like, really, bruh? But at the same exact time, Tank does not have an issue with Genuine. Teresa does, okay? Hold on. Because this motherfucker. And I'm sorry, Teresa went and did a Teresa went and did a post immediately after Tank did his post, saying pretty much saying I'm just gonna summarize this, pretty much saying that they have many different people itching to be the third damn person. He really was. I was just like, oh, they both for that shit. But as my sister, Lady Nika, said, and she said it best, Tyrese just needs to shut the fuck up and sing. And she's definitely right. Because here's the thing, all three of those men, they have phenomenal voices. You know, they all have different ranges, and in their own right, you know, they do they shit differently. But what I'm not here for. Yeah, but it's like, but what I'm not here for is this Mitch shit, this bitch assness. You feel what I'm saying? Now, I do have a theory. The theory could be that either A, they're using this for all three of them to come back together. He does. To come back together for an album, or he's just using this to hype up the album that either he and Tang are going to do or they're going to do with another fucking person. But I think it's some bitch ass shit. Some straight up bitch ass shit. And I don't like. It's not, but what I will say, and on some real shit with Teresa, okay, here's the thing again. I'm a fucking baritone. And like I said, I grew up listening to fucking baritones. Grew up to when you listened, you knew it was a man singing and not a man trying to sound like a bitch. Okay, Teddy Pendergrass, Luther Vandross, Gerald LaVert, Eddie LaVert, okay? Those motherfucking singers, where when you heard them, you knew, oh, all right, now they finna give it to me. So I do like the fact that Tyrese is still giving you that and not trying to sit here and come and try to do all of those fucking falsetto runs and everything else. But, and like I said, his voice isn't standoffish. But if you look at his, if you listen to his voice compared to most R&B, I sound more like a tenor because how I'm talking right now. Trust me. Trust me. I'm a baritone. Trust me. Baritone with a bass register. Just like I'm talking right now for, and like I say, it's the reason that I talk as high as I do. But no, trust when I say I'm a baritone. All right, I don't have any reason to lie. But what I'm saying is like I'm used to that. Throw that ass in a circle. Throw that ass in a circle, y'all. That's it, all right? And my voice can go lower than that, but that's all the fuck y'all ass getting right now, okay? I ain't come on here the same. Came on here to get y'all some damn trending topics and shit. Okay. All right. Love and hip hop news. And after this, I have some congratulations and we're done. Okay. Because I know we've been on here too long and I've been talking for too motherfucking long. Right quick, if y'all have not seen my review for Love and Hip Hop, New York Season 6, Episode 2, it is out. The video has leaked. Okay, so check it out, all right? If y'all want to know where the video is, y'all go to my Facebook fan page, facebook.com/spillingallthetea put together. The link is there, okay? Just want to throw that out there. All right. Trust me, here's the thing. I know I'm a baritone because I was in the male acapella group and we all like I had to hold down the bass section more often than not by myself. So we had three. What we did pretty much how do we do it? Because the way they did it was tenor, baritone, bass, where pretty much all the asses were tenors, and I was the baritone with a bass register, so I had to hold down a deep session and all these motherfuckers. We ain't gonna talk about that, damn it. Back to damn Trinity Thomas. Y'all getting me off topic here. Love and hip hop news. All right, now I apologize because I wasn't able to get all the information. I may come back and do a redux and talk about Mariah Lynn coming for my boo thing. She came for motherfucking Monice. And I ain't happy about that shit. I'm not. I might come back for a separate fucking video. Okay. You can say, all right, what thank you. Shit. Stop making me blush now. I'm trying to be serious. I'm mad because this bitch the game for my motherfucking boo. Y'all know I'm team Moniece now. Y'all know. Okay, I call Moniece on her bullshit, but I'm team Moniece. Okay, I love that crazy asshole. I love her. Okay. I wasn't here for it. I might do a separate video when I get the tea, or I might just throw it in a video by itself. Because y'all can see I'm not here for it. But we're not talking about that hoe. Okay, we ain't talking about Mariah Lynn. But actually, before I get into this news, want to let you guys know about the current lineup. Let me bring my damn blood pressure down now. I know. I know she will. But let me bring my damn blood pressure down because I'm getting too damn excited. January 25th, you guys. What is going to happen is Love and Hip Hop New York is going to air at its scheduled time. Immediately following that, Stevie J and Jocelyn's reality show will air right after that, 30 minutes. You wrote with that shit. You wrote. And immediately following Jocelyn and Stevie's show is going to be K. Michelle's My Life. So we're going to get all type. How are you gonna roll in? You know what? I'm mad at you. You rolled in at the end and shit, but that's okay. Y'all, welcome Lady Nika on into the room. She came in the room and shit. But we gonna have Ratchet Mondays come, you know. You know I do this every Sunday. At the same time, you know I do. This is not a secret. You know I do. But starting January 25th. Starting January 25th, our Monday nights are going to be more ratchet than ever. So, also with Love and Hip Hop, there's this girl named Kat Stacks. I don't know this hoe. I don't. But apparently she's had a lot to say. All right. She's had a lot to say about nigger Scott Young and a lot to say about Cardi B. Now, what I want is I'm on the fence about Cardi B, but right now she my favorite. Okay. But I just want to see Cardi B, you know, put the flip-flops on that ass. But this is what happened, okay? So she was on Hot 97, and this is what Kat... I didn't text you because, okay, if... Real quick, so I can let my sister know. The reason I didn't tell you because, like I said, I had went on a almost 8-mile walk. Okay, that was 2 hours. I did it in 2 hours. Came back, you know, showered and all this other stuff, and literally had just enough time to try to get all this stuff together, try to get the setup ready, and even trying to get the stuff, you know, like, because all my technology, like, I had to do a lot in such a short period of time, okay, in such a short period of time, so literally, like, when I press record, I was still over there trying to mess with some other shit before I came over here, so I'm sorry, okay, I'm sorry, I didn't have enough time, trust me. Back to the regular schedule program. So this is what Kat Stacks had to say about, all right, but you did miss it. I talked about your favorite friend, Wendell Williams. Now, I talked about her. Ooh, if y'all leave her alone. But Kat Stacks said this to Hot 97. Cardi B's main fame is making fun of being a hoe. I don't consider her a hoe. I consider her a regular stripper who gets down or whatever. But you're not a real hoe or prostitute, which you claim that you are. It's like Rick Ross claiming he's a drug dealer, but you are actually a CO. And then there's Cardi B claiming she's a hoe. I'm like, okay, if you are a hoe, have you ever had a pimp? Have you ever worked a stroll in New York? Have you ever been escorting? And then she tries to do interviews talking about pimps and prostitutions, and you have no experience in that. Now, before I get on her, you know, talking about all this other shit. Yeah. Well, first and foremost, you don't know what the fuck she's been through. And like I said, there's different degrees. Okay, you have your whores. You have whoremongers. Then you have hoes. Okay. Like I said, even though I call myself a hoe, I'm more of a whore. I'm high class, okay? Like I said, one of my favorite songs is Miguel's Pay Me, because a motherfucker is international, okay? This motherfucker done been to Japan and motherfucking Korea, okay? What I'm saying is, I am a hoe, okay? Like I said, I'm a whore. I just say hoe because it's layman's terms. Now, here's the thing, on some real shit, dare I say it, most of us, we are hoes. Because unless you are an entrepreneur, yes, high price, okay? Like I said, you got to have some money to sit here and fuck around with this motherfucker right here. Here's the thing. let me let y'all know. A whore, first and foremost, is high price, okay? High price. Let me say that number one. A whore is high price. In addition to that, whores fuck in clean sanitary places. Whore, now mind you, one of the baddest bitches to ever do it talked about bad girls, okay? Talking about the sad girls. If y'all know who I'm talking about, just drop it down there. But whores are in brothels. You feel what I'm saying? Whores do, you know, high class escorting where you have to pay a pretty penny to even get in the fucking presence with them. where they run the game to the point where you going to sit here and you going to pop over them coins. I know about Donna, baby. Okay. Those are whores. Hoes are the ones where, yes, they walking on the strip. You sit here, you whistling, hey, God, come here. Because my whole thing is this. Hoes will get arrested faster than a whore will. Okay. I'm just saying. One is more high priced than the other. Like I said, they both, and here's the thing, they both make their money, but I'm going to just say one is a little more honest than the other one. That's all that I'm saying. Okay? That's all that I'm saying. Beep, beep. Oh, shit. I got to play Sedona after this. So, that right there is that. But here's the thing, we're all hoes. Because unless you are an entrepreneur, unless you own your own business and you do your own shit, you're a hoe. Okay? Because when somebody can sit here and tell you to go do this, and you're doing it because you know you have to make that money, bitch, you a hoe. Okay? You a hoe. Point blank and the motherfucking period. If we're going to talk about this shit in layman fucking terms, we all hoes. That's it. It's that fucking simple. It's just what you do is what type of hoe you are. That is it. Thank you. You know what I'm saying? We all. All right, so cut that bullshit. And my thing is this, Cat Stacks, I ain't never heard of your ass, but you coming for her. All right, keep on playing. I'm just waiting for Cardi B to catch that ass. But come to find out, this hoe was supposed to be. All right now. Exactly. Who that hoe? Don't nobody know her. But apparently she has some tweets to put out about nigga Scott Young and Love and Hippity Hop. So I'm gonna read these, and this is gonna be the end of my Love and Hip Hop news. I'm going to the congratulations, and we're gonna be done with the video. Thank you, Deborah, for sharing. Okay. So she says, this stupid bitch Cardi B wanna be me so bad. Your son appear. Oh, mm-mm. Yeah, that was industry puss. That was industry puss. Marilyn was the best at it. All right, now Monica did a good job too, since she started opening her mouth instead of sucking on some dick. Okay, she ready for Mona. Then she says Cardi B pretend to date DJ Self so they can be on Love and Hip Hop. Kind of like at Young Scrap. He gonna be ushered in a minute when they wanted me to do it for the LA show. Yeah, struggle super hit. Now here's the thing. We all know. Well, I'm glad I can teach you something new, but we all know Love and Hip Hop is fake. We know most of these damn storylines are contrived. You feel what I'm saying? We know this. We know this shit is fake. We know this shit is put together. We watch this shit for entertainment. Okay. You know, she did. She sucked presidential dick. She knew what the fuck she was doing. She just should have kept her damn mouth shut. She should have kept the dick in her mouth and kept it shut. But she want to sit here and start run telling that and shit. Fucking shit up for motherfucking people. I'm telling y'all, it ain't safe for dumb hoes out here. It ain't safe. Shit, dumbass. Hey, I'm just saying shit. On some real motherfucking shit, if we had a motherfucking woman that was motherfucking president, and I was in there, and I was sitting here, you know, licking on the pussy every motherfucking day, and sitting here and beating down their motherfucking sugar walls, putting their motherfucking head through the motherfucking headboard. If I was fucking doing that shit, you not finna hit. I ain't finna tell no motherfucking body what the fuck I'm doing. As long as she still slide me that motherfucking money, paying for my shit, I ain't finna say not a motherfucking thing. I will be a motherfucking kept dude all motherfucking day long, let me tell you. Let me tell you, shit. Whew, shit. Calm the fuck down. Hold on. Exactly. I wouldn't have said shit. I wouldn't have said shit. See, y'all working me up. Getting my damn blood pressure up and shit. Okay, let me calm down. You miss me clowning. This is me clowning sober. This is me clowning sober. I'm a different animal when I'm clowning drunk. Okay. But getting back to this motherfucker hoe. Yes. Praise God. Yes, silent. Yes. See, the Bible and the New Testament says, be quick to hear, slow to speak, slow to wrath. That's all I'm going to say. And I'm going to get back to what the fuck this bitch was saying. So then she said, Atlanta casted me for Love of Hip Hop, but told me I had to move 2 months to get back with my ex and cheat on him with the baller. Who cares? Don't nobody know you. Nobody fucking knows you. And then she said, I said no. Then she said, Love and Hip Hop LA made up a storyline and wanted me to be at Young Scrap's girlfriend and made Rich Dollars discover him as a new artist. Fake show. But again, we know the show is fucking fake. My whole thing is this. You have no fucking fame. You done slipped your ass all the way to fuck through Young Money. I had to research the whole just to even fucking know that. And apparently some of that shit was fucking false. So you have no fucking claim to fame. Do not get mad at her because... Exactly. Exactly. Here's the thing. Y'all finna see me do this. When it's on motherfucking YouTube, you gonna know why. But Ike, why the fuck she here, Ike? I just want to fucking know why the fuck she here. Please somebody tell me why the fuck. Because here's the thing. She had her opportunity twice. Let her tell it to be on Love & Hip Hop. But bitch, you denied it. So leave Cardi B the fuck alone. We all know Mona is one of the biggest motherfucking reality pimps out there. Okay? Give me a second, y'all. Just give me a fucking second. Young Scrap chimes in and says, Cat baby, we're not supposed to snitch on lies in hip hop, even though they wanted us to date on TV, hashtag since we're being honest. He also, excuse me, says, me and Cat says we're supposed to be on Love and Hip Hop and date. I really almost did it, people. Everything Cat Stacks is saying is 100% factual. Cat Stacks, I don't like Cardi B doing interviews about pimps and prostitutes when the ugly hoe never paid a pimp or walked the streets. I'm just saying Cardi B wanna be hoe so bad. Then, bitch, I'll teach you how to walk the stroll and work a pimp. Stripping ain't no money. Cardi B might be a stripper, but I'm a street walker. My heart and veins is cold in hers. Chill. Good night. Now, again, I'm trying to figure out who the fuck is checking for you. I'm really trying to figure it out. And then you had the opportunity and you did not get on it. Okay? Yeah, she's a mouth to hold. Okay? Twitter fingers and shit. And then doing fucking interviews and shit. But I'm trying to figure out who the fuck is checking for you. Nobody. You had your opportunity. You didn't jump on it. And again, can we type amen if what I'm about to say is true? We all know Love and Hip Hop is fake. We all know the stripper. Here's the thing. She proud to be in that number. Oh, I'm proud to be. She ain't in the motherfucking number. But she want to be counted. The fuck out of here. The fuck you mean? As old boy say shit. Hell. I done gave y'all a lot of me. Okay. I done gave y'all an hour, almost 10 motherfucking minutes of me. Okay. Put my tablet down. And let's go ahead and let's do some congratulations so we can end this video on a good note. Okay. On a good note. So first, I want to say congratulations to Tiana Taylor and Amon Shumpert. Hopefully I didn't say his name wrong. They gave birth earlier this week to their baby girl. Hey, I gave a lot, okay? I gave a lot. But they had their baby daughter, and what happened is, thank you. Tiana did not know she was going into labor, and she ended up having her baby in the bathroom. And what happened is, if I'm not mistaken, he called 911, and they pretty much coached him through what to do. And I think she said she had maybe within like a minute time frame, they delivered the baby, and he was able to do just enough, tie the umbilical cord. Yeah, it is. They're a good couple. Hopefully, they stay together. I really hope they do. And pretty much was able to do everything, and you know the not well yeah paramedics if you will not the people got there to you know take over and whatnot. But I'm just so happy, and I'm truly happy for them that you know even though she didn't know she was going into labor, that it was quick. She didn't need any medicine and whatnot, and that he stepped up to the plate, and that they have a healthy baby girl. So I'm so happy for them, and not to mention he was on Good Morning America. And and you know he even broke down about the experience. So that is a beautiful thing, and that's black love at its best. So happy for them. Also, Michael Jackson, his Thriller album has gone platinum for the 30th time, people. Who the fuck we know right now doing that shit? Nobody. Okay, keep sweating, let y'all know ain't nobody doing that shit. Right now, okay. Unfortunately, yes, it's one of those things where exactly nobody. It's unfortunate that yes, you know, this happens after he passes away. But again, let us not forget, it's been platinum quite a few times before he passed. So you know, like I said, I gotta clap it up for you know, Michael. Like I said, that album again is platinum for the 30th time. What else we got? Now I'ma say this. I'm gonna let y'all drag her because I'm not going to drag her. I would assume that his children are probably getting the money. I would assume, but I don't know. I'm not there. But I'm about to give a congratulations to somebody. I'm gonna sip on my damn Crystal Light. I'm gonna hit my vape. I'm going to let y'all drag this next person because I'm not gonna do it. I'm just gonna congratulate this next person. So, Ciara's song, I Bet, pretty much has become 2015's first platinum female R&B song. Congrats to Ciara. Out of my damn train. So, congrats to Ciara. I'm not gonna drag her, but I'm gonna just let. I'm just saying, I'm not gonna do it. Yeah, apparently, I didn't have enough time to sit here and fact check to see if anybody else had a platinum song. But hey, congratulations, Sierra. I'm gonna leave it at that. Cause here's the, even if y'all don't drag us, she probably get drugged in the motherfucking comments. So congrats to her. What else? Oh, Papoose. Ooh, shit crickets. Oh, shit. Papoose and Remy Ma, they actually tied the knot this past week. So congrats to them. All right. Well, they retied the knot, if you will. It does. If she is the first, it does. But Remy Ma and Papoose, they redid their vows, if you will, and had a formal wedding. So again, congrats to them. And we'll get to see some of this play out on Love and Hip Hop. and we have two more childbirths. Khalees has given birth to her second son, so congrats to Khalees. And Lady Nika's estranged husband, Dwayne The Rock Johnson, and his girlfriend Lauren, I guess Hashian, they have welcomed a baby girl into this world. You got froze. All right. So those are the congrats, you guys. That is it for tabloids and trending topics with T. I'm going to let you guys know this video will only be up probably for like another hour and a half because because here's the, let me put it this way. When I post to YouTube, it's coming off of Periscope. So if you guys came in late, I recommend that you guys go back and catch the replay. If not, catch it on YouTube. So I want to thank all of you guys for joining me this Sunday afternoon. Again, know that, and I'm saying this again, this is for Lady Nika. I do this every Sunday at 1 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time where I'm at. I do this every Sunday. And if I don't, I will let you guys know well in advance if I'm going to have to shift it to the left or the right. So thank you guys for joining me with the new backdrop and everything. I ask that you guys check it out on YouTube when I add all the extra stuff. Thank you guys so much. So you guys have a blessed Sunday. Capricorn season is right around the motherfucking corner. Two more motherfucking days. Cap season almost here. And my ass gonna be motherfucking 29 in a handful of days, y'all. So again, thank you guys so much for watching. And for the YouTube, please rate, comment, subscribe, and share. I will see you guys for the next video. And yes, I'm doing the Real Households of Atlanta later on tonight. So I love you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. Peace.